The key for having good navigation for your site is to help your site visitors find what they want in the fastest and the most efficient way possible. And if you don't know where to get started, the best place is to study your competitor's website. For example, if you have just built a WordPress site speed optimization plugin and you're wondering how to structure your site navigation, then you could check out prominent competitors on the market such as WP Rocket. They have some main menu items here and they are very descriptive. As you hover over them, they have dropdowns that helps their site visitors find what they are looking for. They have a sign-in link, which is for their existing customers, and a call to action button for potential customers. And right at the bottom, there are some important links as well, which includes the language selector. With that information, you can quickly identify which items are important for your site navigation. So in this video, we're going to talk about the best practices you should know when deciding on your site navigation. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress sites. And this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. So now let's talk about the best practices for site navigation. A detailed breadcrumb helps site visitors quickly find their way around your site and go back to earlier pages. And it also helps search engines better understand your site structure. For example, if you visit one of HubSpot's blog content, you will see the breadcrumb right at the top. It tells you that this page belongs to the marketing category. And if you go to any of Search Engine Journal's pages, you will see the breadcrumb right at the top of the page. It tells you that this page belongs to the content marketing category. So many big websites display the breadcrumbs for the benefit of their site visitors and the search engines, and you should do it too. As a RankMath user, you have the option to add breadcrumbs on your pages if your WordPress theme does not have that function. Simply go to RankMath's General Settings and click on the Breadcrumbs tab. Now the WordPress theme I'm currently using is already integrated with RankMath, so you do not have to do anything additional. And you can customize the appearance of how your breadcrumbs look like. But if your theme is not integrated with RankMath, you will see something like this, where you have to add this set of PHP code in your theme files, or this shortcode in your page template. But the important thing is for you to activate the breadcrumbs function and save changes. Now let me show you an example on how to add breadcrumbs on one of your pages. You want to copy this shortcode. Let's visit any of your posts. Let's save this. Let's check out how the current page looks like. As you can see, we do not have any breadcrumbs here. So now what we want to do is to add breadcrumbs right after the title. We will add a new blog. Let's search for shortcode right here. And now we want to paste the shortcode here and save changes. And now let's visit the page again and refresh it. And you will see that the breadcrumbs is added over here. This page belongs to the BBQ maintenance category. If you want to learn how to implement breadcrumbs with RankMath on all of your pages, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Now, this really depends on the business you are in. If your key business goal is to get your customers or potential customers to perform one specific task, it would make sense for you to add a prominent call to action button to the navigation menu. For example, in RankMath, the specific task would be to download the free RankMath plugin and teach our customers or potential customers on how to use our plugin. So we have a call to action button in our navigation menu. And when you click it, you will start downloading our free RankMath plugin. And this leads you to our thank you page, where we will show you how to set up our plugin from scratch to have an SEO-friendly website. If you are new to RankMath, we highly recommend that you check out this video. If you don't want to view this video through this page, you can go to our channel and search for RankMath tutorial, and you will see the video right here. With a clear call to action in your navigation menu, it helps guide your site visitors towards what you want them to do on your site, whether it is a product, service, download, sign up, or whatever, without having to search for it. Doing this would not only improve user experience, which could lead to better SEO, it can also boost sales if done right. However, if your site sells a lot of products like Amazon where there is no particular focus, then it would make sense not to have a specific call to action. For example, if you visit Amazon, you will see the shopping cart at the top right corner, because that's what you go to Amazon for, to buy stuff. There is no specific task or a call to action here. So it really depends on what your business is about, but having a clear call to action when it makes sense will help both SEO and business growth. And in the same category as the call to action is the sticky navigation. If you have a call to action on your menu, it makes sense to stick it to the screen so that at any point your potential customers decide to take action, there's a call to action button stuck to the screen. For example, on RankMath, if our potential customer consumes our content and decides to take action, you will see the call to action in the sticky menu. The same goes for businesses like HubSpot. As you consume their content, you will realize a call to action button in the sticky menu as well, because the goal is for you to take action by clicking on this. Another thing to mention about sticky navigation is that if you have a piece of information-heavy content, you should consider having your table of contents in the sticky navigation. For example, if we visit Wikipedia, as we scroll down this long piece of content, you can see that the table of contents is sticking on the side of the page. This helps your site visitors navigate to the part of the content they are most interested in. So use these elements like the call to action button, sticky menu, and the sticky table of content if it makes sense to your business. I made this mistake when I was a beginner, and I hope that you can avoid this after watching this video. Now, I'm going to reenact my mistake, and nowadays, you hardly see any pages with this type of navigation, even ranking on the search engines. You see, as I hover over one of the menu items, you will see a long drop-down of items. And there is another nested drop-down right at the bottom, which opens up a longer drop-down menu, and which opens up another drop-down. And it is very easy for a misstep and a whole drop-down closes up. This is a very horrible navigation menu. If you have lots of items in your menu, you should consider using mega menus. So that's one of the mistakes I made as a beginner, and let me show you what I mean by sites with this type of navigation menu will hardly rank on search engines. Let's go to Google and search for best WordPress themes. And let's visit, for example, page 15. And let's check out all these pages that are ranking all the way back for that keyword. Alright, this page, it has a mega menu, looks very cool. How about this page? There's nothing much in the menu and it is clear cut. And how about this? This is clear cut as well, and this is very organized. There is no nested dropdowns. So even with pages ranking all the way back, they do not use nested dropdowns anymore. If they have a long list of items, they will use something like this, which is the mega menu. So this points to one thing. Keep your navigation menu tidy, and if you have lots of items on it, use a mega menu. The key is to help your site visitors find what they are looking for easily. Content-specific widgets like related articles or explore more topics enhance navigation by giving users quick access to relevant content. They eliminate the need for extra searching and hence improving the site experience. For example, if we visit one of WP Rocket's blog posts, scroll all the way down to the bottom, assuming that I've read the entire article and you see some related articles, you'll be inclined to learn more if they matter to you, right? On top of improving the site experience, the time that your site visitor spends consuming the related content sends a good signal to the search engine, and it may improve your search rankings over time. Plus, it creates internal links as well, which is favored by the search engines. If your website targets audiences in different languages, you should have menus that serve each language using SEO-friendly practices like hreflang tags. For example, as we have seen earlier on WP Rocket, right at the bottom, there is a language switcher. Let's select, for example, the French version, and let's right-click and view page source. Let's search for the hreflang tag. This is the language search engines understand that the same page has different language versions, and they are not duplicated pages. Now, if you go to IKEA, you will have the option to switch the language and region that is nearest to your location. And if you visit RankMath, right at the bottom, you will see the language switcher, where you can change the language of the page to whichever you are most comfortable with. Visit its page source, and you will see that there are different language versions for the same page. So if the same page is translated into different languages, you have to use the hreflang tag. And there are a couple of ways to implement a multilingual site, and we have discussed this in detail in this video right here. The link is in the description if you're interested. Now, this really depends on what your website is about. If your website is about selling stuff and profiting during the festive season or events like Black Friday or Cyber Monday, then this site navigation may apply to your site. For example, if we check out Walmart's Black Friday deals page, we will see all these navigational items to help people find what they are looking for to buy during that period. So adjusting your site navigation for these trend-sensitive pages can help boost engagement and sales during that period. And one more thing that wraps all these best practices is to use Heatmaps to track the performance of your site navigation. Heatmaps allows you to see where users are clicking and which navigation elements are being ignored. This data can help you optimize the site layout by either moving or removing underused items and adding high-value pages to prominent places of your site.
You can use tools like Hotjar to track your site navigation. As you sign up to Hotjar, they will provide you with a tracking code like this, and you have to paste the code in the head section of your site. So let's copy this code, and in your WordPress backend, it depends on the WordPress theme you use, but for most themes, you would hover over Appearance and click on Theme File Editor. Then on the right, you want to search for something like header.php. And over here, you will see the start of the head tag, and this is the close of the head tag. You want to paste the code right before the head tag closes and update the file. And once you have done that, go back to Hotjar and verify the installation. And now Hotjar will start collecting data from your site, and it will tell you the exact places people are clicking and a percentage of it. You can even view the video recording of the visitor's mouse movement when they are visiting your site.
This is incredible information, and you can use it to benefit your business. So these are the best practices for site navigation, and if I have missed anything or you have experience on this topic, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you haven't subscribed to us, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.